I'm looking forward to a great game. Thank you so much for all you do for hockey.
Well, we had the coach interviews that I did, and of course I didn't start the play-by-play portion of the stream, so we'll get those between the periods, but they're very good. And about 4 minutes with each coach. A lot of the things we talked about had to deal with how they were going to respond to a game like this. It's a section final. The word final is a reason, because it's over for somebody and you move on if you're the other team. So we will hear from those two coaches between periods, and looking forward to making it a wonderful night here for you from the Eden Prairie Community Center. So for those of you that are tuning in right now, we are going through the starting lineups. Eden Prairie Eagles enter this one at 17-1-2. Meanwhile, the Minnetonka Skippers at 12-6-2. Both have had terrific seasons. They played twice on this campaign. For the Eagles, it was a 9-5 win when they opened up the conference play earlier on in the year. And then they went on to tie 2-2. At the Pagel Activity Center. That was quite the contest, to say the least. Tight checking, playoff style, and one of the things we talked about with the coaches is what to expect in a game like this. And I think we're going to have some pace, but I think we're going to see both teams go to their bench. They both have a lot of talent from which they can call upon. So section playoffs, we're not at Mariucci. Really kind of a cool vibe to be here at the home rinks of all of these teams, as we have a number of games. We have 9 section finals that are playing down here tonight, and then we'll have 7 more tomorrow. We'll pause now for your national anthem. All right, folks, here we go. We've got the peasantries taken care of. Your starting lineups are in the can, and we will be prepared to bring what should be a terrific high school hockey game to you, the Section 2AA final. If you want to bounce around, I know many of you are Eagle and Skipper fans, and you're going to stay here with us. By the way, on the chat, let's keep it chill. If it gets lame, you're out, and we're taking it down. So, John Sands, you're monitoring the chat. You heard me, right? If it's lame, we're shutting her down. Thank you. So far, so good from what I'm seeing. Look at that, me flexing the muscle. Imagine that. Skippers will be wearing their blue and white trim sweaters. Eagles in their familiar white, black, and red. Both teams have depth. Both are willing to open up the play a little bit. The Skippers enter this contest so far, averaging 3.65 goals for. Meanwhile, the Eagles, 5.3 goals for. The power play has been really kind of a key thing in this matchup between these two teams. The Eagles are 4-for-6 with the man advantage. Meanwhile, the Skippers are 0-for-3. The Eagles not prone to going to the box too heavily here in this one. We're underway as it's going to be played in by Hannes. That's going to be Mittelstadt off the boards. Bear plays that to the near side for Kiffin. He'll bump the boards back into the Eagles zone. There's nice intensity in the room right now. We can feel it as it's playoff hockey here from Eden Prairie, Minnesota. Batchelder reaches for it. Boy, what a season he's had. Carter Batchelder, 27, 24, and 51 on the season so far, and he is a finalist for the Mr. Hockey Award. There's another one. Luke Mittelstadt over to Cam Langfels to Batchelder through center as they're clean through. Whoa, that took Riesmeister by surprise. That big shot in on him. Now it's Batchelder off the side of that, knocked away by Riesmeister. To the near boards it goes. Nice little play. Good stick there. Back through center it goes. And in deep. Hendrickson will chase down. That was Tyler Keppers that made that nice play in deep. It's going to be thrown back in by Wyatt Chartier. Turned aside by Zach Hayes. Boy, has he had himself a season. Just because you're on a talented team doesn't mean you're a good goaltender. He's won a couple of games for this hockey club, and he was terrific against Holy Family Catholic. That in the first period as that one trickled in. Paddle down for Breesmeister. The Eagles are content to dump it in and on goal. Now it's Hendrickson back in behind as he tries to fish that one through. And now it's going to be at center ice off the stick of Chartier. He stood up by Mittelstadt, swiped away there by Hayes, and now it's Mittelstadt back up the left wing side. That gets behind Hartle, and now it's on the stick of Burchild. Rink wide he goes for Whipple. Alec Whipple to the right wing for Chartier. Nice feed over to Quinn. Quinn leads the team in goals with 10 off the end boards at goal. So now here's it's going to be Langfels. He's going to be bothered by Quinn off the end boards. Langfels and Quinn. Now it's big Blake Anderson off the end boards as well, as he's going to give trouble. Langfels with it, shovels to center. Off the glove of Burchild as he's going to regroup. Whipple will take the left side. Burchild over to the right. Nice feed over to the near side. Brink will play that to the left wing wall as it's going to be Luloff with it now as he looks back up off the glass. Nice little chip into the neutral zone. Now it's Kiffin with it as he's watched by Riku Brown. Boy, has he come on. He's been a house of fire. The big power forward, the senior playing like one. We mentioned 29 seniors in this hockey game between these two teams. You win with seniors, no question. Luloff across the line as that's deflected away by Bear. And now it's going to be Brown with it. Brown will try to position himself against Newhouse. Now it's Langenbrenner. Pushes that one through wide of the mark. Now it's going to be Luloff with it. He'll be checked on the play by Bear as it's Feinberg now watched by Kiffin. Kiffin fishes back into the corner and Newhouse will come away with it. Angles a pass to the right wing side for Brink. Ahead through center. That's off Langenbrenner's stick. There's a foot race with Hannes to the corner. Hannes showed right and went left. He's bumped by Langenbrenner with Newhouse there to help. Brown comes in to help. Now Jackson Blake steps out. It's going to be picked up by Langenbrenner with 13:54 to go here in the period. Now it's Langenbrenner. We're scoreless. If you've just joined us, Luloff to the left wing. Winds off the glove of the goaltender, Kyle Breesmeister, as he makes a save. Let's take a look at your goaltenders here tonight. Kyle Breesmeister, 7-2-2 on the season with a 1.78 and a 9.29 save percentage. He's also marked three shutouts in the Eden Prairie zone. You've got Zach Hayes, who's 14-1-2 with a 1.52 goals against. How about this? A sizzling 937 save percentage, and he has four shutouts to his credit as well. Set back in by Langfels behind the net. Konen now with it. He's watched by Holt. Sliding down to make the play there was Timmy Lagerback. Now to the left wing side, it's Farina to play this one in behind. Now it's going to be Hayes, wraps that one around to the right wing side for Blake. He better watch it because he was hit by Lagerback and Blake comes back with it. He'll play it to an open, nice little subtle feed to Batchelder. Two on four across the line, he can create. Pulls an escape, look for Blake in the high circle, but that's going to be picked off by Farina. Nifty move. Oh, tripped up by the center red line, and in deep it goes. Back in behind the net it goes. I have to talk to Bob Lanzi and his crew. Well done. I'm kidding. Now it's played back through center. It's Blake with it. Blake sends some sauce to Holt as that bounces the stick, and rolls over to the near boards. Now it's Langenbrenner with it. He'll walk to the left wing side. He's going to be forced to escape. Nice defensive play by Chartier. Hendrickson on it, knocked away from him. Briesmeister's there. Every chance that trickles its way toward the goal mouth area, you can feel the tension in the room. That's going to be sent the length of the ice, and icing will be the call. Back into skipper territory we go. Haven't really been any grade A's yet for these two hockey clubs. However, I'd say the Eagles have had the majority of the possession and the opportunities across the line. Blake now for Luke Mittelstadt, rink wide for Jake Casey. Snapper, that's knocked away from traffic. That might have hit Anderson on the way through. Now it's Quinn. He's stood up by Brown. Luloff is there. There's Anderson to take his ice away. Birdchild for Whipple to the near side. Here's Whipple, long pass, left wing for Quinn. Casey gets a stick on that. Quinn will ring that back in behind. Now here comes Brink to the corner. Brink will dust it off, looks through the slot area. Birdchild with a carom. Back in behind for Quinn. That's too high for Brink. Now over comes Whipple to play this back into the corner. Brown will pit fish this to an open corner. Casey and Quinn come together. Now it's going to be Brown with it from the right wing side to center. Birdchild rings that back in behind as Hayes will set up with Luke Mittelstadt to take over. Here's Luke Mittelstadt looking back up through center ice. He accelerates. He found some real estate, took it. Wrister in on goal. A nice save made by Briesmeister as he got big on that one, got the catch glove over, and hangs on to the faceoff to his right with 11:29 to go here in the first. Eagles will get a line change. One of the things on that game at Pagel that I really enjoyed was the chess match of line matching between Sean Goldsworthy and Lee Smith. It was a nice cat and mouse game there. We'll see if that continues here from the community center. To the left wing, off the stick of Hannes. Now it's going to be Langenbrenner over for Britton, ahead for Holt. His pass hits Keppers. Up steps Langenbrenner. He finds an opening and plays that in on goal as Briesmeister's going to hang on. The faceoff will come to his left. And we'll see what we have. We have the pairing of Bear and Kiffin. And then it will be Newhouse, who's taking a double shift at center. And he'll be between Farina and Lagerback. Newhouse was instrumental in the Skippers' win against the Lakers of Prior Lake. Up off the netting and out of play. We're going to take this one outside the zone. Winner of this one moves on to the state tournament. Again, we mentioned there's 9 section finals happening tonight, of which we have our very own Patrick Lilia stationed at the Plymouth Ice Center, where the Trojans are taking on the Red Knights of Benilde St. Margaret's as well. We also have our partners where we provide play-by-play talent, and our own Brandon Spratt on the call. That one with Breck and Delano. Puck is played back in. Boy, that Thompson's a good one in goal, I'll tell you. He could be a Brimsek winner in my book. Near side it goes, but he's not on the list. Hartle plays that one in wide of the mark. Oh, look out! Johnson forces the turnover. Down the line they come. That was Hartle. And now it's going to be Birdchild to center. That hit Jorgensen with a high stick. And we'll bring that back into the Eagle zone with 10:22 to go. Anderson while draw now against Marble. Anderson the clean win back for Bear, but he had heat. Nice job coming off the wing position or the center position. That was Peltier rather from the wing position to make the play. Now Anderson tried to play that down the rail. That one's deflected. Now Caring sidesteps up the left wing side. His pass is cut off by Quinn, who will take this one across line. Langenbrenner reaches. Back to the corner it goes. Anderson working the frame to the corner as he comes together with Caring. And there's a little bit of help with Manning as well, who comes away with a back door. Nice feed there. That was Quinn, who was lurking for number 11. That one's deflected away. Over to the near boards it goes. Drew Casey goes down on the play. Back in behind it goes. It's going to be Langenbrenner walking to the right wing side. That pass too far for Peltier. We'll see if it has enough for an icing call. It does. And back into Eagle territory we go. Eden Prairie Eagles have been to the state tournament 12 times, 92, 99, 01, 03, 09. They were champs, then took a year off in 11. Were champs again in 11. Of course, those were the Raul Letty era. Then they went on a tear here, 14, 15, 16, 17, took 18 off, 19 and 20. Quite an impressive run for them. Meanwhile, for the Minnetonka Skippers, eight state trips, 85, 90, 94, 06, 10, and 18. There's Newhouse with a chance. That one doesn't get through it. Of course, they won that championship led by Luke Lohite in the club back in the day. Off the glass. That set the managers packing. They didn't quite duck, so we'll give them a little bit of credit for sure. Man, share this link. This is going to be a dandy. I think this is going to go for a while. We may have overtime here tonight. Did I just call it out? Very tense matchup. Mittelstadt over for Langfels. That's Feinberg that tried to play it ahead. Now Langfels comes away with it across the line as they straddle in deep. It goes as Bear comes away with it. Hill outlet to the right wing. That's cut off by Brown on a nice read of the forecheck. Locked in on that wing. Now it's going to be Hendrickson for Chartier. Feinberg pushes down the wall. Now they're going to push this one to an open wing. That's Kiffin. Boy, has he been good this year for the Skippers. Solid defenseman to the right wing. That's Harris with the shot in on goal. That's greeted into the midsection by Hayes. He'll hang on to that one. Now you look at the output of offensive production here for the Eagles. Batchelder 27, 24, 51. Drew Holt 17 notches himself with 30 helpers. And then Jackson Blake 16, 29, and 45. I think for Blake that was in about 15 out of their 20 games. Absolutely, those guys, that trio just lit it up like a Christmas tree. And it opened up things for the rest of this roster. They have a number of players in double digits in points. Drew Casey pushes behind Peltier. Races to the corner as he's going to play it to an open wing. Now it's going to be Whipple. Anderson looked back over for Whipple. Drew Casey, four checks. Now it's Marble who comes away with it, works it toward the slot area from the knees. Casey tried to swat that one through. Now it's going to be Birdchild that's on it from the right wing as he's going to carry it ahead. Now it's going to be Brink. They turn it over. Drew Casey finds an opening. Wise play there to get it deep as he heads to the bench. They get new troops on. Now it's going to be Whipple outlets to the left wing side. Farina shovels to center. Langenbrenner had that roll up on his stick a bit. Now it's going to be Conan across the line. Conan carries deep. Steered out of there. Oh, a big rebound as Hayes had that go not where he wanted it to. Now it's going to be Newhouse with it. Now it's back into the corner. Keppers is there. Keppers from the corner. Knocked away from him. Here comes Holt as he accelerates back up ice. Drew Holt hangs onto the puck. Shovels one. Oh, Blake tried to go from the outside in. Conan said no. Now it's going to be Blake again as he comes together with Conan. So hard to move off the puck is Jackson Blake. There he is, angling up high. Oh, and he found Langfels a little bit too far for there. I didn't think Langfels thought that was going to squirt through. That one trickles up and out of play into the bench area. 6:59 to go. I got to ask Paul Ospie if it's better to be here. Is it better to be here or Mariucci? Here. Yeah. I like the 85 foot as opposed to the 100. All right. So he's indifferent. A professional. He's happy all the time, perpetually. That's awesome. Of course, Paul Ospie, a player agent, looking at some of this fine talent here. Plenty of it. Harris to the right wing for Chartier. Two on three across the line. Stick save Hayes is going to gobble. He's going to hang on to that one. Get the faceoff coming up inside the zone. Go, Hello to Matt Harrington, who's on board. Bob Gibbons. Dave Ranheim is watching from North Carolina, watching Brother Paul's edition. Paul is ensconced in the middle of the bench right now. Hartle, you don't think me and Paul haven't broken it down a few times? I know Dave knows that. Back into the corner it goes. So, Dave, great to have you on board all the way from North Carolina. Bob Gibbons from Marietta, California. I always want to say Georgia, but I never do. I leave that to Bart Archer, who's not here, who's vacationing right now. Took the week off. Now he's actually on a work trip, but just thought I'd throw that out there. Sent in deep. See if he's listening. Over to the near boards it goes. Skipper's ahead. Andrew Nealon somewhere. I don't know where he's at, but he's on board too. I mean, there's a long list. We'll try to get to you. Now Langenbrunner finds an opening wide of the mark. Kiffin, long pass. Nice job up to Brink, but a good read by Mittelstadt to thwart that opportunity as it's Quinn with it. Off the boards, he hits Luloff. Now Anderson, and it's going to be picked up by Kiffin. Kiffin now will protect. Jammed on the play. Feinberg there. Nice forecheck there. And look out. Luloff, that one's pushed wide of the mark. And back into the zone it goes. Ooh, that took a shallow angle. Batcheller! Oh, he can snipe there. That was a break for the Skippers because it landed on the sniper's stick. And it'll trickle its way into the Eagle zone for an icing call. Tomorrow night, we'll have Rozo Moorhead for you right here at DMNHockey.TV, so be sure to check that out as well. Been a busy section playoff for us here, and it's been great. We've had an absolute blast calling these games. Trickles up off the netting. Obviously, we've gone to the automation. We have these in rinks around the state of Minnesota, looking to expand that a little bit further. The idea is to get as many games as we can as possible. And it's been also used as a coaching tool, because there's a lot of things these coaches can do with it. So the overall depth of what the product can do has been terrific. Luke Mittelstadt steered off the glass. Now it's Kiffin with it. Kiffin's going to push back in behind for Bear. And now it's on the stick of Keppers. There's Langfels to make the read on Farina. They're caught in offside. That's turned off the side of the net by Hayes. Here comes Mittelstadt as he edges his way to the near side, but Farina, unimpressed, plays the body. Now Batchelder tries to carry through center, but Farina's moving the wickets, and he's going to jam Batchelder into the bench area. Now it's Bear with it. Long pass. Carrying knocks it ahead to Holt. The speedy Drew Holt finds the slick. Jackson Blake is, that one's knocked away. Look out, Newhouse can fly. Up center, carrying calmly gets it off the near boards as Blake will come away with it as he's going to work it toward the goal mouth area. Harris pushes over to the corner. Now Holt with it. Holt back up for Batchelder. Now it's Langenbrunner with it. He'll push it to an open corner and said, let's play fetch, boys. Let's see what we can do here. Now there's Blake. Nifty move off the end boards. Tried to find Batchelder. Knocked away from Blake. Now it's picked up by Chartier. He finds Harris across the line. Oh, nice stick there by Langenbrunner to break that up right at the line, denying entry. Now it's carrying with it. Now Holt. And a delayed offside on the call. Three and a half to go here in the first period. We're scoreless. We're going to hear from Sean Goldsworthy at the period break. talking about the depth of these kinds of games and what they mean. Looking forward to that. Now Harris with it. Back into the corner behind the net it goes. Hayes fishes at her on. Nice job by Harris to the corner. Chartier wedges together with a couple of eagles. Nice job to cut that off. Look out! Oh, Harris tore the goal mouth area ahead. Hendrickson. Now to the near side it goes. Hartle. Whipple knocks it away. Burchild slides it over to the left wing side as he plays up to Quinn. The one thing these skipper defensemen have done so well, and I credit Jack Hillen and his coaching with, they transition their footwork east to west as well as any group you're going to see 1-6. By the way, hello to John Hillen, who's watching on from Scottsdale, Arizona, working on the tan. Now it's going to be played from the line, set right back in behind. Hayes will set this one up for Mittelstadt. Left wing for Luloff. Luloff kisses the glass to center. Conan gets in front of Brown. It's knocked up by Hupka. Now it's going to be Brink across the line. Brink is stood up on the play by Langfels. Now it's Conan blasting around. Ooh, watch out for that one. Took kind of a funny hop around the boards as it's going to be back up ice with Mittelstadt. He'll play it to the right wing. Feinberg there to might make a nice play to keep it alive. And now it's going to be Brown with it as he stood up on the play by Hannes. Brown for the Eagles. Hannes with the body check. Tom Gertis wanting a penalty, not getting it. I don't know what for, Gertie. Now it's going to be Luloff. Luloff flips that one ahead. We're not playing checkers. Off the end boards it goes, and icing the call with 1:48 to go in the first period. Newhouse draws with Batchelder. They got the top lines out against each other here toward the latter stages of the period with a 1:40 to go in it. Blake try to work that one around. Newhouse, who turns over. Here comes Blake. He's dangerous. Shoots. Scores! Oh, you give Jackson Blake the slot. He knows what to do with it. And nobody, Selly's better than him with the self-check into the wall. It's 1-0 Eagles. That's most undoubtedly going to read Blake unassisted on an even strength tally. And it's 1-0 Eden Prairie late here in the first period. Here's Caring with it now as he'll lay that one back in behind. That was cut off. And now it's going to be left wing side. Bear steps into this one across the line. He looks toward the slot area. Nice read there by the goaltender Hayes. He had Harris breathing down, stayed focused on the shooter, looked it right into the catch glove. And we'll get a change of players here for the Eagles. The skippers will keep this group out. They want the senior Brown to go against Hendrickson in the faceoff circle, and the freshman with the quick mitts gets the job done. Off the end boards, it's going to be picked up by Harris. He's watched by Mittelstadt. Harris tries to work it down the wall as Joe Cook, your public address announcer, announces last minute to play in the period. Now it's going to be Hendrickson wedged on the boards. Hendrickson, nice play there to Chartier. Mittelstadt pinches him up on the wall, pins him neatly. Now it's going to be Brown. Held on to it for a bit, still got it to Mittelstadt. Look out. Oh, that took everybody by surprise as that's going to work its way back into the skipper zone. That was played around the wall by Breesmeister, the goaltender here for the skippers. And for Jackson Blake, that goal winds up being his 17th of the season. Mittelstadt long pass. That's off the stick of Conan. Right wing on the feed, Lagerback. Now Luke Mittelstadt with it. Now Jackson Blake. Works that one ahead. Here comes Newhouse as he turns back against the grain. And that's going to do it for the first period. And what an entertaining first period we had here from the Eden Prairie Community Center. The score reads 1-0 in favor of Eden Prairie. We're going to take a timeout. We'll listen in now from head coach Sean Goldsworthy as I caught up with him before the start of the game. And we'll have this interview. If you were here with us at the start of the contest, we somehow this didn't play, but we're playing it now because there's some really good stuff here to listen from Key, this coach here. We'll hear from Lee Smith after the second period. And you're in another section final. I believe, what is this, your third in a row?
No, we actually got upset the last term. So we had a couple hiatus there, but we've had a pretty good run. And, you know, the year where we probably had the best team, we, had a little hiccup in the semis there. So our kids are used to big games. I know it's nice to play in these, but I'm not a result guy. I'm more of a process guy. And, you know, our kids are ready.
A weird year for sure as far as the schedule, everything. Does it feel the same, though?
You know, when you get to this point, it does. It's actually the last probably 2 weeks have felt normal for the kids and for the coaches, the staffs. You're kind of getting into the playoff time. It's been worth it, you know, all the extra work, all the, you know, hoops that we had to jump through to make sure the season had its start, and then we continued through. But it does feel like normal. I was just saying to my buddy the other day, that's the beautiful thing about Minnesota is that hockey didn't miss a beat. And we kept going. We had two state tournaments relative to other sports, and kids had a season.
And then in terms of, let's just get into the game real quick, obviously you had that 9-5-1 here, really crazy game, goals flying everywhere. And then you had a tight checking 2-2 tie at Pagel. I have a feeling this will be somewhere between those two because there's that playoff thing. What do you think is going to happen out there? What are we going to see?
Well, I think early on in the first game here, you know, we were chasing the game from the first period on. So I thought, you know, we played better in the second and third period. It got into some penalty problems, and you can't do that against their top unit. So, you know, we've been there and done that against those guys. At our barn, it was a little bit more tight checking. I think that's just historically as both teams start to figure out what their lineup looks like. Eden Prairie is a really good defensive team, too. You know, they don't take that lightly either. So I have a feeling it's going to be a little bit more tight check tonight. It's going to be a little bit more involved five-on-five hockey. Both teams know each other really well. These kids have played against each other since they were squirts and peewees, so they know each other up and down the lineup. So I think it'll be a really good pace game. It's going to be a little bit more disciplined.
What has been the area of this team that you've been most pleased with? Maybe that, I hate the word surprise, but maybe, you know, went past what you thought they would do as a group.
This group, to me, the word that describes them is they're just resilient. You know, these kids in every community, but really the group of kids that I have this year, they have done everything I've asked them to do. You know, delay in the season, no problem, coach. Keep doing captain's practices, keep working themselves through, getting ready for the season, no problem, coach. Miss a couple games, no problem. Anytime we got knocked on our butt and had to respond, they did. You know, we've only been beaten three times in regulation. So these kids bend, but they don't break. They really work hard. They buy in it as a group. We play a lot of guys. We don't shorten our bench. And I think that favors us this time of the year. And these kids have shown that they're resilient.
And then one of you tonight are going to have to say goodbye to your team. You'll never see the same group again. And that means some seniors that have played this game for a long time with the blue M on their sweater move on. How tough is that as a coach? I mean, because you get vested with these guys. So one of you guys are going to have to go through this.
Well, you've kind of prepped it a little bit. You know, these kids live in the moment. You know, you deal with high school athletes. It's 24-hour windows. So we have 13 of them. And I think Eden Prairie's got 16. So there's a lot of seniors on the ice tonight. And you're right. Someone's got to go home. And both these teams probably deserve to get to the state tournament and do well there. Our section has shown that when you get to the state tournament, historically, at least in short memory here, you're pushing for a title. So, you know, it will be tough. I think we kind of put it in the rearview mirror and just focus on the moment right now and put forward. But these kids know there's going to be a ton of energy. I don't think any team's going to have an easy time putting anybody away. But there's just too much on the line, and these kids have worked too hard to get this point.
Sean Goltz for the Minnetonka Skippers. Good luck tonight.
Thank you. Take care.
That was Sean Goldsworthy, the head coach of the Minnetonka Skippers. We'll hear from Lee Smith between periods number 2 and 3. It's 1-0 in favor of the Eagles as they lead the Skippers here from the Eden Prairie Community Center. We should have what will be and entertaining second period coming up for you in a matter of minutes. Thank you. And we welcome you back to the Eden Prairie Community Center. What a hockey game we have here between these two clubs, pouring it out there. And we have some scores that are we can give to you. Maybe some of you are probably trolling the scoreboards, but for those that aren't, if John Sands could pull me up Scoreboard Central here, our producer. Right now at the Plymouth Ice Center, it's Wayzata 2 and the Red Knights of Vanilla St. Margaret's nothing. I'm telling you, that Trojan team is a tough out. I don't think they get seeded, although one could argue they could or should. They are a good, good hockey team, and I know that Pat O'Leary is happy with that team, and he's got a club that's fully bought into what he's looking for them to do, and because of that, it's not a disjointed thing. These guys are playing structured game with some physical play and generating scoring chances and doing one heck of a job. What other scores do we have? Right here. I want this. There we go. St. Thomas Academy and Rosemont are in action. What did I see on the score for that one, John Sands? It's just an absolute gong show right now. 2-0 St. Thomas Academy over Rosemont. Lakeville South is inching past Lakeville North by a score of 2-1. We're 1-0 here at the Eden Prairie Community Center. Eden Prairie leads the Skippers. Mentioned that Wayzata is getting their ice done right now as they lead Pinellas St. Margaret's 2-0. Breck in Class A action leading Delano by a score of 1-0. And then I saw a score Andover 1, Grand Rapids nothing. And also Hill Murray, I believe, is up 1-0 over the Bears of White Bear Lake as well. John Sands, our director here, is going to work to get me as many shout-outs as possible so we can work the Harry Carey angle high school hockey style. If anybody knows, half of the reason I'm doing this as a profession is probably because of the great late Harry Carey. Oh, there's a chance as they blow their way right into the goal mouth area. And the net with Breezemeister knocked off its post, but that was something right there. It's been an interesting season from the scheduling perspective. So a lot of projections have been going on with, well, this team is this team's that. And you just really have to play each other to know where everybody fits. I mean, that's conventional wisdom for sure. Blake, the faceoff, pulled back by Newhouse. Skippers have been good in the faceoff circle tonight. They come back through center with Keppers. Newhouse waits at the line, back in behind the net it goes. It's going to be Newhouse to the corner as he's going to play behind for Keppers with a feed out front. That one was knocked away. Langfels was there. Here comes Blake. Finds Batchelder at center, knocked away from his stick. Now Kiffin with Batchelder on him. Bear around for Hannes. He'll have it now. Looks back to the right wing side. Nice pass. Oh, he feathered it. Over for Keppers. That was gorgeous. Now it's going to be Batchelder with it ahead for Blake. Blake, 2-on-3, knocked off his stick. He'll have to hurry to get back online. Batchelder, good recognition there to circle back. Now he gets Blake. Touch pass. Batchelder, the give and go. That's over the glass, over the net, off the glass. Now behind the net it goes. Kiffin with it. Kiffin will do a little spinorama. Blaze that off the end boards for Bear. Here's Bear with it. Chips the glass. Newhouse knocks that away from Caring, and it's going to be back into the Eden Prairie zone with Langenbrunner. Oh, look out. The stick knocked out of the hands of Chartier. Langenbrunner's pass deflected away. Now Caring will guide it ahead for Luloff as he's watched by Hendrickson. Now it's going to be picked up by Hupka, back in behind the net for the Skippers as he draws in the forecheck of Feinberg. Now pinching off the left boards there was Brown. It's Kiffin away with it for the Skippers. Ahead he goes to Harris. Nice little feed for Hendrickson. Edges across the line. Oh, and a quick shot there. Rebound. Oh, that one was blocked by Caring. Didn't get through. Around the wall it goes. Now Conan was there. Oohs and ahs here from the crowd on that last scoring chance. Harris to the back door. Now it's going to be Luloff who comes away with it. Back up through center ice. Luloff accelerates. Conan had the hipper. just buried himself off the turnbuckle. That was incredible. Over to the right wing side it goes. That nearly put the door through the wall. Now Konen plays this to the right wing. As now it's Langfels watched on the play by Quinn. Quinn now with it. They'll play this one too far. That was for Hartle, and that's going to be whistled down for an icing call. Wow, that was something else. So Luloff has got wheels as he's racing up the wall. Konen does the hipper totally. Somehow Luloff just buries his way through there and just, I mean, he had to beat. I know. David LeVake saying that's an Indiana Jones move right there. I mean, I'm trying to explain it, but you had to be here to see it. Just the thud was beautiful. I mean, it's something else, and Konen gets up, no problem. Now here's Bear with it. Over to the right wing side for Kiffin, loads it up. Oh, a nice stick save by Hayes. Kiffin with that leg pump, put a little juice on it, got it on the ice. And the good goaltender that Hayes is, steers it up and out of play, gets it out of harm's way. As the Skippers bring on the Newhouse Keppers Hannes edition to face off against Batchelder, Holt, and Blake. Middlestad turns away from Keppers, waits on it. Nice job to boot that one up to the stick from Batchelder. Blake's shot's deflected by Kiffin. There were some assists on that Blake goal. I think they were kind of phantom. Maybe I was looking at a different game, but nonetheless, the assists went to Holt and Langenbrunner. I guess they're in a contract year, so they got to hit their bonuses. Officials are feeling generous. I guess maybe, I don't know. Now it's Blake with it. Face off, Bear. Holt cuts that one off. Keppers was there. Blake swings away at that one. Now Kiffin up to the line. Now it's going to be Middlestad with it. Middlestad lets a shot go. That's knocked away there by Breesmeister. Hello to Doug Gornseif, who's on board with us. Good to see that he's hanging with us. The ex-Hornet fan. Now I think he's become an Eagle skipper. It's the late conference. We're a family. That's what we all like to say. Now it's Batchelder behind as the Eagles press in the offensive zone. Langfeld's shot's deflected off shins. That's Hannes with the shiver there. Now to the right wing side. Keppers plays that one in wide of the mark. Hayes comes away with it. He looked to play that one through as it's going to be Langenbrunner with it. Look out. Here comes Hannes. He's been playing heavy here tonight for this Minnetonka Skipper Club. Now it's going to be Langenbrunner with speed through center. He's got Holt to the left wing side. Birdchild watches Langenbrunner. Nice battle to the corner as they fence. Now it's going to be picked up by Batchelder. Down he goes. Fans want a penalty. It's playoff style hockey, folks. We're just going to go. Hand pass. No penalty there. I like this 5-on-5. And when we hear from Lee Smith between periods, I think he said it's going to be much more of a 5-on-5 game than maybe what a regular season might have a few more penalties in it. No way. Sarah Dahl is cheering on the Eagles from 30,000 feet on an airplane. Wow. Back in behind it goes now. It's going to be look to the slot area. Oh, he scores! Harris ties it at one! Oh, the Skippers fans go nuts. They're on the glass. And we're brand new here with 12:40 to go in the second period. I believe our guy Todd Mulligan is on board here tonight too. Thanks for joining us, Todd. Wow, 1-1, tell a friend, share the link. This is gonna be interesting. I just have a feeling. Now it's Newhouse. Oh, score! Oh, I thought that went in. Scores! It did! Hunter Newhouse gives his club a 2-1 lead as the goaltender, Zach Hayes, was hand pumped. The puck dribbled down on the goal line. It rattled away. And then there you saw Newhouse. Uh-oh, he gave a little bit of a chirp to the bench on the Eagles. We'll see if that wakes them up a little bit. Two to one now, Minnetonka. A couple of goals just seconds apart. Blake now plays this one ahead for Batchel. Their Manning was there. Here's Konen. Konen puts on the brakes. Around the wall it goes. Lagerback watched by Blake. Now Holt plays the body. Up to the line it goes. Mittelstadt, quick shot that's deflected up off the netting and out of play. To go here, but the energy to my left, our left, as we're looking at the camera, which is known as the skipper side, is dialed up, and the Eden Prairie fans have responded. You wouldn't know, we've got like a couple few hundred people in here. I mean, it's incredible. Newhouse to draw. Face-off win by the Eagles. Langfels, now he lets it go. That's blocked by Newhouse. It's going to be Jorgensen to the corner. Back in behind, Hartle works it away from Bear. Here comes Newhouse. He's cut off on a play by Johnson to the line. Langfels is going to have to retreat to the neutral. Gets that over to the left-wing side for Mittelstadt. Here's Mittelstadt across the line. Now it's going to be Kippen that's there. Kippen comes together with Johnson. Now here comes Newhouse as he has some real estate. That's deflected by Hartle. Good play with the stick there. Back into the Eagles zone it goes for Langfels. The intensity and just the next step of speed is picked up here in this hockey game. Quinn with a hit on Jorgensen. Big collision between two skippers at center. Wow, the student section for the Eagles love it. Now it's Johnson to play that one back in and around. It's going to be Mittelstadt waiting on that. Up to the line it goes for Hartle, finds an opening. Now it's going to be sent right back in by Quinn as Langfels is going to regroup behind the net. Langfels didn't have much. He flips at the length of the ice. And back into the Eagle zone we go for the ice. Hello to Chris Langenbrunner, Webster Cruff. I hope I got that right. Tata Batchelder, Karen Seeger, Chris Wilson. Wils, how are you, buddy? Mark Howells, Bob Hupka, Luella Britton, and many others. We'll get to the rest of you that have checked in on our chat. Love to fire those shout-outs for you. Appreciate your viewing here tonight. Hupka with it to the left-wing side. Rung around the wall all the way to the far side. Cut off by Lager. Back, ooh, got the feed from Newhouse, and now it's going to be Langenbrenner. Long pass ahead. Did Batchelder get it? No, he didn't. And we'll bring it back down into the Eagle zone once again. The Eagles allow 1.45 goals per game, and in their games this year, they allowed 5 right here at the Eden Prairie Community Center to these skippers, and then 2 back at Pagel, both, well, the one for sure well above their yearly goals against as a group, but skippers know how to find the back of the net, that's for sure. Here comes Jorgensen, knocked away, nice play by Bear, love that kid. Up the left wing wall, Langenbrenner plays that back in behind. Now it's going to be Kiffin with it. Off the boards it goes. Checked on the play was Harris. Now back into the corner, Britton and Chartier come together. Now it's on Hartle's stick. He's stopped on the play. Hendrickson down the wall. Chartier, that missed the mark and back to center. Oh, it hit the linesman right back on the stick of Bear as he plays that one back over for Kiffin. Chartier deflects that one in. Now Langenbrunner. And oh, look out! Nice feed, Hendrickson. Oh, he had Harris. Manning through traffic. Oh! Scores! A feed from the back door, Harris! From Hendrickson, 3-1 Minnetonka. The first shot came up high on Hayes, took him by surprise, kind of left his feet as it hits the glass, deadens itself down. Harris goes right where he's supposed to go, to the low slot area, gathers it in and punches it home on the ice. And it's 3-1 Minnetonka as the Eagles, wow, call their timeout. Get your reset here. So in a 3-minute and 2-second span, Harris, Newhouse, and Harris scores his second of the game for the Skippers as they go up 3-1, and they turn the complexion of this thing around. The Eagles just complete their timeout. It is electric in here. Like, I've never experienced this building. I've been some big ones, but this is next level. Blake tries to feed that out front. Now it's Batchelder to glove that one down. Knocked away, back into the corner they go with Konen as he turns to the right wing side. Keppers looks ahead. Oh, that one hit Blake on the way through as Langfels will retreat back into his own zone. Blake pushes that off the boards as Langfels comes away with it. Now Blake takes this one in stride, gets away from one man. Oh, and a tripping call. Blake gets it back. Now it's going to be Batchelder through traffic and possession to Blake Anderson and the Skippers. And now we talked about the power play of the Eden Prairie Eagles. It's 4-for-6 against this Skipper team. And one of the things Lee Smith talked to me about at the pregame interview was he's expecting to see a different look on the PK from the Minnetonka Skippers. And why wouldn't you if you're lighting it up 4-for-6 during the two games you play against them? With the man advantage. Whoa, hello to Kelly Wagner. She's on board. Big face-off win by the Skippers. Back to center it goes. There's Harris. Now Langenbrunner. Langenbrunner walks his way to the right side, leaves that one back for Batchelder. He'll be wedged by Newhouse, gets away from a stick there. Now it's Blake down the wall, tries to play it to the corner. On the stick of Langenbrunner, glove down by Blake, nice control there. Off the skate of Mittelstadt to the corner it goes. Mittelstadt watched on the play. Wedged by Bear, Holt helps out, nice job to Fish. Langenbrunner, ooh, nearly snapped the twig, looked like he did, but he didn't. Now it's going to be Blake who comes away with it. Gets through one stick check over to Mittelstadt to the right side. He gains the Skipper zone. Behind the net it goes. Knocked away. Now it's on the stick of Blake. 1:05 to go on the power play for the Eagles. Sauce, Mittelstadt shot. Oh, that one was blocked. Bear giving it up for the squad. Back up to the line. Langenbrunner now back over for Blake. Top of the left circle. Didn't like what he saw. Escapes back up for Langenbrunner. Mittelstadt now right circle in front. Score! Oh my word, the power play is just sizzling for this Eden Prairie team. It's now 3-2 with 7:37 to go in the second period. My. Well, there we go, a power play goal for the Eden Prairie Eagles. Really created by the footwork of Jackson Blake, which drew the penalty. And we'll see where the ebbs and flows of this one takes us. As the Eagles win the power play, Jake Casey ahead for Jorgensen. Glass and in it goes, back in behind the net. Now it's played around to the right side. That's off Jorgensen. Oh, look out. That goes to the front of the net area. Now it's going to be Harris. He has two. Up the... Community center. Down goes Hendrickson. And now here comes Johnson, 3-on-2. He's going to dump it in instead wide of Griesmeister. Hupka is there for the Skippers. Jorgensen for the Eagles. Now it's going to be Johnson, Hupka, and Conan. Jorgensen as well. 2-on-2 battle. That's a tough guy sport down there out of the corner. Check thrown there by Hartle. He's going after them all. But ahead it goes to Anderson. Has a nice job by Quinn to absorb that hit. Now it's going to be Langfeld with it. He's flushed. He'll stay on it. To the center ice area it goes. Sent right back in by Quinn behind. Jake Casey will dance into this one. Nope, he'll let it go for Langfeld. Langfeld's nifty move there to the left wing side for Hartle. This line's been out. They're going to need a change. Delayed offside on the play as the Skippers touch. And here comes Casey with it. Jorgensen spreads it up high from the Eagles off his stick. Now Skippers control with Hannes. Hannes across the line to the right wing. That one misses the mark. And now it's across the line with Brown. Oh, nice move. Look at that skill. Up to the line. Nobody home. All the way back into the Eagles zone it goes. Here comes Langenbrunner. Now it's going to be Caring. Skippers lead 3-2 here in the second period. Back it across the line. Caring looks out front. Oh, Griesmeister paddle down as he hangs out of that one. Eagles trail, offensive zone draw for them. Skippers win it. Out of their D zone they go. That's going to be cut off by Luke Mittelstadt. Oh, Matt Schelder. Oh, a glove save. Nice look into the catch glove of Griesmeister. Just how you're taught as a goaltender, square up, look it in. He did that beautifully. Doc Jensen's on board. Jack Jensen as well. Hope you guys are enjoying this one. Boy, I missed the two of you. The Glory Days, number 18, patrolling it right here at the EP Community Center. Those were some great times. Britton now, around to the corner, goes for Holt. He'll accelerate ahead. Now it's going to be Batchelder. Oh, fortunate for him, he lost the handle. He would have been offside by about a half mile. Batchelder, oh, he went high blocker, pad save. You can't let the guy shoot. Something's going to happen. Back in behind, now it's going to be Blake. Blake is watched by Newhouse. Bear is there. Batchelder walks out of the corner. Back up for Mittelstadt. Mittelstadt pushes it back over behind the net. Now Holt will race this one. Instead, he's going to get help from Batchelder. As Batchelder looks at it, it's going to be picked up by Farina. Not a bad idea to alleviate the pressure and get it the length of the ice. 4:41 to go. And if anybody... Peter Brady. It's only the second period. Better go to the water. It was time for change. One of the best songs on sitcom television. Conan. That's off the glove of Caring. Oh, Hayes is going to go Showtime thinking he's Alex Stalock. Got a couple guys back in behind. Eagles are way offside. They're going to take this one outside the zone. I think you'd take it all the way down, but I don't know any better. They're going to talk it over. There's four of them out there. They're going to look at this. So I think the big discussion is we had two guys tangled up in the end, which is why he was off. But once one guy retreated and the other guy was in, they just said, you can't. We're going down here. And does it matter? Talk about it all the time. Faceoffs do impact games more than people really consider. It's not just to make it happen. Oh! Great bid from the goal line. Shots on goal in the first period were 6-5 in favor of Eden Prairie. Face off, pull back, push to the right side. Conan, that shot from Hupp is deflected, knocked away, back and behind. Brink, oh, nice feed off the back door. Look for Anderson. Now it's going to be Jorgensen with it. Now Langenbrunner takes it off the boards. Looked ahead for Hartle. Hupka back in behind. Four to go here in the second. Over to the right wing side. Conan shovels to center. Langenbrunner was there. That's off Hartle's skate to the near side it goes. Jorgensen across the line. Can't get it in as that hits Quinn. But right back onto the stick of Jorgensen as Conan tried to clear. But instead Hupka from the near side. Up the wall it goes to Quinn. Boy, it's like absolutely a war on that right wing wall. And the fans are loving the hard work right in front of them there of the Eagles. Now it's going to be Conan with it. Back in behind. Hops the stick for Hupka. Here comes Feinberg. That's off his stick as it rolls back into center. No ice on the play. Now Langenbrunner looks ahead for Luloff. He'll take this one in stride as he takes it to the corner. Anderson gets the big body in on him. Forces the turnover. Birdchild is there. Look out. That one started trickling toward the front of the net area. Kepper's now. He'll play it to the rink wide left wing side for Hannes. He reaches. He's hammered by Luloff. Goes down on the play. Puck still stays along the wall as it's going to be Birdchild with it as he waits for things to open up for the Skippers. He's got options. He's got Hannes on the near side. Brown is trying to take that away, but there he goes to Hannes, left wing side. Ahead it goes. This is going to be a rolling puck in Newhouse. Junior across the line for Holt. Fanned on that. And now it's going to be off the legs of Batchelder. And now it's going to be picked up by Birdchild. Back into the center ice area it goes. It's Langfels. Batchelder. Looks like Hannes lost his twig. He's going to pick that up. Long ahead it goes. Look out. Here's Blake. He's dangerous. Blake is going to play that ahead for Holt. Now it's going to be Bear calmly to center. Langfels will play it right back in as the Eagles will touch up with 2:05 to go here in the second. Skippers lead 3-2. Out front. Oh, Bear. Nice. Look at the calm demeanor of the... Bring the wall back over to the far side for Holt. Jammed by Chartier. Here's Newhouse with it. Stood up by Batchelder. That one's deflected. Off the end boards it goes. Here's Chartier. As he's jammed to the right wing side it goes. Batchelder with speed across the line to Blake. Blake ahead to Batchelder, but off the skate of Bear to the corner. It's Batchelder out of the corner. Lost the handle. Hendrickson hammered by Batchelder. Blake had a Holt open, but couldn't quite get it there. Tried to make a move. Hendrickson, nifty little pass along the line for Chartier. Back into the neutral zone it goes. We have an ice. Here's Sean Goldsworthy, Jack Hill, and Steve Aronson and his coaching staff. I think you, of course, Tom Streeter, my good buddy, I think you'd say, you know what? 3-2 lead, I am into this. Let's get this to the room. Maybe see if he can't add on to it off this offensive zone faceoff. Hendrickson's so good in the circle. Brown, though, gets this one. Now Mittelstadt takes over. He'll look back to the left wing. That's Luloff, another number 17. He and Conan have squared off quite a few times here tonight. Now it's going to be Langfels with it behind the net for the Eagles. Left wing they go. Mittelstadt wants to flutter one for Feinberg. Nice job to get it behind the back in on goal as that's Briesmeister to hold on. The faceoff comes up to his left. Don't forget, we'll hear from head coach Lee Smith of the Eden Prairie Eagles with a pregame interview. We talked about the game, the things that surround it. Batchelder and Newhouse. Newhouse the draw. Blake gets a stick in on Hupka, but Hupka comes away with it. Ooh, we nearly had Newhouse. No ice on the play. They'll say that he got that, did Newhouse. Now Langfeld's better hurry, gets it ahead to Blake. 37 to go in the period with Batchelder across the line. There. Back over the near boards it goes. Now it's Holt, plays the body there. Two on two from the near boards, knocked away from Farina. Batchelder goes down. Farina had numbers across the line to the right wing side. They'll be just offside as the puck kind of rolled away there and gave him some trouble. 15 seconds to go here in the third period. Or second period, rather. Just checking. Just testing. See if you're listening. You would think there's 15,000 people in here by the energy. It's just unbelievable. Blake now is going to hold it. Ooh, went safety valve to Mittelstadt. Now Blake comes back away with it. Mittelstadt down goes Hannes with 1 second to go. Mittelstadt tried to pull the trigger, but there's Kiffin to thwart that would-be opportunity as the skippers head off. Wow, to the locker room as they had themselves one heck of a period. Three goals in the 2 minute, 2 second period, and that has made it. Shifsky has a hat trick for Andover. They're up 3-0 in the second. It's now 3-1 against the Grand Rapids Thunderhawks. We'll get all the scores gathered in for you. And for the time being, we'll take a quick timeout. We're gonna hear from Lee Smith from the Eden Prairie Eagles. This is, of course, an interview that I captured with him prior to the start of this hockey game. You've been in a few section championships. We're with Lee Smith, the head coach of the Eden Prairie Eagles. This is nothing new for your team. It's different, though, because you're not at Mariucci.
A lot different game, not being at Mariucci. I don't know if the nerves of going down to Mariucci aren't here, but the nerves of playing a really good Minnetonka game are still here. We know that we have to be really good tonight to move on and go to the state tournament.
Big difference, though, is you have 15 feet less. It is a little bit more tailored to how the kids play all the time. And I think for a lot of hockey purists, that's a good thing.
Yeah, I think at the end of the day, it's a good thing to be playing at. I'm just glad we're playing. You know, in a year of COVID, it's outstanding that the State High School League allowed us to have this game tonight, to have a state tournament. And whichever team comes out of this game tonight is going to be a great representative of Section 2AA.
We're moving into the last week of March. We're usually spring breaking. Your tan is usually a golden bronze. You know, it's a different time of the year, but it's still a...
matters. It matters to them. It matters to us. A lot of people have sacrificed a lot of stuff over the years. Parents, players, coaches. It matters.
Your team has, 16 seniors? They have 13, I believe, on their roster. We had 28, 29 seniors out on this ice tonight. Every year, I'm going to ask Goldie this question. I'm going to ask it to you. Every year, you guys got to say bye to them. One team in the whole state wins. Everybody else has to do it after a loss. Tonight, one of you are going to have to do that. How hard is that to do after you've been with these kids for so long?
It's incredibly difficult because we started with them when they were mites. And as we look out here right now, there's mites playing. And that's the kids that we watched grow up, and now here they are. And we want to see them succeed tonight.
And you've done this over and over and over again. And the relationships continue to evolve. I mean, can you think back over your glorious career, like how many great kids you've had? And like, it has to be a little bit surreal at times.
You know what I'm proud of? They're not only great hockey players, but they're great dads now. I have guys that are great dads, and I don't know, it's crazy.
Grandpa's pretty soon.
Yeah. it's been a great ride, and I've been very fortunate. I got really good families here. I got a good staff that I work with. It's a lot of fun.
Hockey question for you here on ice. 9-5 game, that was wild. You had the 4-1 lead, it's 4-4, and then you kind of pull away. Then you get back over to the Pagel Activity Center, and it's a tight checker. It's 2-2. Playoffs tend to create a little bit of urgency and nerves in people, right? Especially when they're well matched. Do you expect this game to fall somewhere in between those two games as far as feel?
Yeah, I think it'll feel more like the Pagel one though than the first one. I don't think they were playing their goalie that they have out there right now with us. And so I think it'll be a different feel tonight for sure.
Your power play is 4-for-6 in two games against them. It's impressive. How good is it clicking right now?
You know, on what's happening. We just got to be ready. I'm sure that they're going to have a strategy, obviously, to defend it differently than in the past, and we're going to have to execute.
We'll be watching for that upstairs. Looking forward to a great game. Good luck, Coach.
I'm looking forward to a great game. Thank you so much for all you do for hockey.
Thank you. Hey, buddy. I'm going to beg to differ a little bit because I do think the power play matters, especially in games like these. And I think he wouldn't disagree as they cut a 3-1 deficit to 3-2 on the Jackson Blake goal. So when we take a look at the goal scoring in this game, Jackson Blake opened it up for the Eagles in the first period. They took a 1-0 lead into the break. And then in a span of 2 minutes and 2 seconds, Graham Harris scores at 12:40. Then Hunter Newhouse scores at 12:30, 10 seconds later. And then at 9:30, it's Harris again. Then Jackson Blake gets his second of the game on the power play. Or no, check the Batchelder on the power play midway through the second period. We're a few minutes away from the start of the third. Go ahead, get your chips and drink. Let's roll. We're going to have ourselves a great-looking third period coming up for you as we continue high school hockey at the MNHockey.tv. We take a look at your out-of-town scoreboard. It's getting interesting out there. Dicey now as Grand Rapids cuts their 3-1 deficit to 3-2 with the Andover Huskies in the Section 7 AA final. Some other scores for you from around the league, and it's been a heck of a night. That much we can say. Lakeville South and Lakeville North are tied at 3. Andover Grand Rapids is now 3-2. We're 3-2 here at Eden Prairie. St. Thomas Academy pretty comfortable against Rosemont, 4-1 in the 3-AA final. Wyzetta 2, Benilde St. Margaret's nothing going into the third. Delano leads Breck 3-1 in the Class A. Hill Murray up 3-0 on the Bears of White Bear Lake. Well, what do we have in store for this period? I mean, like, anything? I mean, it's just, have we done it all yet? I mean, it's been intense. Holt plays that one around to the far side. Batchelder was there. Now it's going to be Blake. It's going to be interesting to see how these two teams respond. One with the lead, one chasing the game in the Eden Prairie Eagles. Holt tries to deflect in deep as it's Kiffin. Now it's Hendrickson around the wall. Far side for Conan as Harris will wait on it. Now it's Langenbrunner. Holt comes across the line. He'll load it up. Ooh, try to go through the legs. Shot. Oh, a pad save. Briesmeister. Oh, good look there. That was Batchelder who pushed that one in on goal. Chartier now tries to cut to the middle. Batchelder will accelerate to the right wing side. He tries to find some room as Harris is there. Ooh, Batchelder with a stick could have gotten the cross check there. Now Blake plays this one ahead. Back into the corner he goes. He turns away from traffic. Chartier knocks to center. Now it's going to be Johnson with it for the Eagles. He'll accelerate to the right wing side as Anderson jumps off the boards and bumps into him. Now Conan pins up Johnson off the end boards. It's Chartier with it. Hops the stick of Harris, or Quinn rather, to the near side for Hartle. Hartle had Johnson, nice feather on the feed there. Hupke, though, breaks that up, disrupts it beautifully. Now Johnson off the end boards. Anderson is there. Now it's going to be on the stick of Hartle. Middle stat through the goal mouth there. Is that bounced in on the goaltender? Briesmeister, cool as a cucumber to get the pillows down and cover that one up with a butterfly and keep that one out of the back of the net. We're just about 2 minutes into this one, with 15:05 to go here in the third period. We've been on these Eden Prairie Eagle home games, Minnetonka Skipper home games all year long. We've seen these teams play just about everybody, at least within their conference and section. And there is no doubt that this game is everything you would imagine and more. Lou off to the right wing side. That's knocked away from him as he gets it to Luke Mittelstadt across the line. He'll sit on it. Oh, look at that little move. Whipple with a nice body there. Oh, look out. Brown nearly with the turnover. Oohs and ahs here. That's like a big miss. Putt in front it goes. There's Feinberg with it. Shallow angle opportunity for the Eagles there, and Briesmeister's been tested here in the early going. Nine sections out of the 16 in the Class 2A and 1A will be decided here tonight. Seven more tomorrow. And back out of the zone they come with Lagerbach. He'll play this behind the net. Karina is there with Langenbrunner. Now Lagerbach wheels that one out of the corner. Up for Kiffin through traffic. That one just misses the mark. That was seeing eye. Now Holt with it. Over to Blake. Blake waits for some room to develop, but there's Karina on the back pressure. Look out, Newhouse is dangerous. Back into the neutral zone it goes. Karina steered out of there by Hayes. Now Newhouse behind for Karina. Karina through the front of the top of the crease area. Oh, a big shot taken there from the left side by Bear. Reaching out with the glove was Hayes to hang on. Now for the past few minutes. The Skippers have sort of pushed back a little bit here. Back to the line it goes. Nice job by Hupka to drag that one and push it off the wall. Over to the far corner it goes. Harris comes away with it. Hendrickson pushes it up. Now Jorgensen for the Eagles. Tried to play that one ahead, but Chartier will come away with it as it was deflected. Hartle, too much juice. That's going to be an ice. Knowledgeable Skipper fans clapping for that. And out comes the line of Blake Anderson. Be joined by Jack Quinn and Joe Brink. Oh, there's a glove save. That came from Hupka. Just quickly caught it and pushed it through. In on goal. Some movement into the circle there as the backside linesman said, hello, fellas, let's hold on now. Now it's going to be Mittelstad with it. Behind the back for Langfels. Now Feinberg, that's off the stick of Brown. Konen off the stick of Brink. Now Mittelstad, rink wide he goes. Feinberg, here goes Brown. He can accelerate through center. Look out, Kiffin's got him though. Now it's going to be Brown, a shot and a save. Oh, they're going into the net, hard they go. Big save by Breesmeister. Will they get the goaltender interference? I highly doubt. I'll tell you what. For an old school 80s goaltender, I'm not going to say much. That was about every other play. It didn't matter. It was just constant. All I'm saying is it'd be nice to have the gear these guys have and not have to deal with that. Actually, yours truly kind of like it. Now Batchelder will take the draw for the Eagles against Newhouse. Blake back up for Langenbrunner. Over for carrying. Through traffic, that one's knocked away off the shin of Kiffin. Now Holt back to the corner. It's Newhouse. He loses the handle. Blake has it. Bids for the hat trick. That one deflects wide. He gets the puck. It gets awfully quiet. Everybody gets to the edge of the seat, no question. Now it's going to be Newhouse with it. He's a flyer as he gets it for Kepper. Just misses the mark. Penalty coming up. Looks like Caring's going to go. No, it's going to be on the Skippers. Oh, my word. I thought it was on the Eagles. So Newhouse is going to go. I didn't even see what happened. So the Eagles will get a power play. They're 1-for-1. Now in the matchup, 5-for-7. And we'll see if my discussion with Lee Smith between periods at the start of the game where he said it ain't going to matter. I think what he's getting to is you got to play 5-on-5 to win these games. But special teams, ask my guy Mike Randolph, works on it since their squirts. It's such an important part of the game. The kill, critical here for the Skippers. Back in behind it goes, Chartier through center. Oh, he nearly sprung Harris. Mittelstadt, though, just gets the stick out and knocks it away, and he'll find Batchelder with it. Here comes Batchelder. They'll have to go 200 feet. Batchelder will gain the line. Langenbrunner watching on from his team. Back in behind, Konen is there. Nice job to fish out away. There's Blake. Now to the corner goes for Holt. Now it's Harris. Holt, Harris, and Mittelstadt from the corner. 2-on-2 battle. Where are we going to go with this? Fished out of there by Batchelder, but pressure by the Skippers. Langenbrunner cannot keep. That's the Skippers win the battle and push it off the wall into Eden Prairie territory with 1:10 to go on the power play. Here comes Batchelder, gets away from Anderson, over for Blake. He'll angle through center from right to left now. Cross the line, leaves off for Langenbrunner. Langenbrunner's going to ring it hard behind for Holt. Holt will get there from the end boards to the corner. Bolt back up for Langenbrenner. He's dangerous. Down low. That's deflected. Batchelder. The shot pass to the high slot area. Went up off the netting. We'll bring it back outside. .11:08 on the period. 50 on the power play, and the Eagles are going for broke. They're keeping this group out for the full two unless they score. Now it's going to be Mittelstadt with it. Back over for Langenbrenner. Across the line, he plays this back into the corner. Now Kiffin is there. Cuts that one off. All the way around it goes. Mittelstadt. Puck is rolling, but not when it gets on the stick of Blake. Calms it right down. Push back over for Mittelstadt. Oh, they got Blake open near side, top of the left circle. Shoots. Oh, that one snuck through. That one's knocked wide. Nice pad save by Breezemeister. Saw it through a forest. Now off the side of the net they go. Quinn is there. He accelerates. Big win there for the Skippers. They're going to kill this one off. Eagles will have one breakout to go with 10 seconds to go on it. And now it's going to be Batchelder. Langenbrenner to the box. Outsteps Caring. Now it's Batchelder's. He tried to dice through, and that's going to be dumped back into the Eagle zone. But 10:15 to go here in the third. Skippers leading 3-2. Back up the near wall it goes. And to the center ice area. It's Tonin. Look out. Hayes saw that at the last second. Now Mittelstadt with it. He is going to skate away from Chartier and play this back in behind. That's cut off by the goaltender, Breezemeister. And now it's going to be Hendrickson from the left wing side. Here he comes across the line with Chartier, 2-on-5. Waiting for support. Does a great job to get that back in behind. Now it's going to be Brown with the body there. Chartier comes away. Back into the corner it goes. Langfell's now on it. And now it's to the right wing side. Keppers, now Brown. He stick checked with it. Now Luloff will accelerate. Keppers tried to get a piece of that. Instead, it's pushed back into the skipper zone. Burchild bumps with Luloff off the end boards and back into the center ice area goes. It's been a 2-minute, 2-second period in the second period where the Skippers blew up for three goals. That's the difference, 3-2 where we sit right now. Now it's Burchild, flips it high to center. That's off a stick, I believe. No, they say it won't be. And we'll bring it back down into the Minnetonka zone. Shelder pulled that draw all the way back into his own. Britton. Now for Langenbrenner. Holt knocks it to center through traffic. But there's Duke Kiffin to play that one rink wide. Bear finds, ooh, nearly found Newhouse. And icing. Back to the Minnetonka zone we go. Now these kids have been going at it since squirts. Let's be honest. There's nothing new here. When it comes to games like these, you throw the records out. I'd be curious to see with how these... Oh, there's a faceoff win. Oh, Batchelder nearly pulled the trigger. They try to push it through the slot. It's dangerous. And the big sticks of the Skippers clear it to safety. Luke Mittelstadt. Now for Langfels. Holt takes over. Nice touch to the right wing side for Blake. Blake tried to feed Batchelder, drew another penalty. So this will be the third penalty for the Skippers as Farina will go. Sean Goldsworthy less than pleased. I think he, it kind of, well, it looked like he lost an edge to me, but did he lose the edge because a stick got in on the hands or whatever? I don't know, but we'll just leave it at that. Faceoff win by the Skippers, Harris. So Vinny Farina goes for the slash. 7:55 here in the third. Should be now the third power play for the Eagles, second of the period. Newhouse is going to make it hard on Langenbrunner, who drops that back for Blake over to the near side for Batchelder. Back in deep it goes. Hupka was there, chops at that one, comes away with it. Nice job by him, as he'll go hard off the boards to center as Langenbrunner gathers, though, over to the left side for Mittelstadt as he'll gain the line. He'll protect it to the corner. Here's Blake. Back door. Score! Oh! That power play is just deadly. We're tied at three with 7:26 to go in the third period. The patience of Jackson Blake. Back over to Drew Holt. And the three-year letter winner ties us at three. I'm looking at David Levesque right now as he's penning his piece for the Minneapolis Star Tribune. He's had to rewrite his slug a few times. I wouldn't be writing anymore right now. Obviously, he's talking about the goal, but goodness. Drew Holt with his 18th of the year. Now it's Mittelstadt for Hartle. The pace across the line. Here's Hartle. Watched by Harris. Hartle tucks that one to the corner. And now to the line. Chartier knocked away from him. Jorgensen's there. We know one thing's for sure. We're going to have at least one more goal here tonight. At what time, we don't know. Now it's going to be carrying. 6:43 to go in the third. Langenbrunner, Hartle. That's off the top of the bucket of the linesman. Took it like a man. Oh, nearly turned over Brown there. Now Feinberg, Brown reaches. Luloff gets through the stick of Hannes. They pin up off the boards. Brown tried to play this one through. They knock away. The heart and work of these two teams has been incredible here tonight. Can't say enough about these guys. Now it's going to be gloved down. And held on to, actually, by Hannes off the near boards. We're going to say take it inside because the Skippers pinned it up against the body. So they go down low. 3-3. The big guns have been scoring for both of these teams here tonight. The leaders. Newhouse has been amazing. There's Lagerback. Oh, did they miss that one at the line? Oh, no. To the right wing side, there's Langenbrunner's shot. It's going to be a moot point. Taka parents are all over the linesman right now. The masks are even coming off. I don't blame them. Wondering what the hell's going on. Holt now in Newhouse. Nice win there by Farina. Luke Mittelstadt knocks that one away. Lagerback. Langfels. Now Holt with it. Oh, look at that turnover. There was Newhouse. Now it's Langfels. Fanned on that, but Holt supports. Back to Blake to the right wing side. He'll regroup to Mittelstadt. Top of their own zone he goes. Holt tried to deflect that to the oncoming Batchelder, but that was read neatly by the Skippers. Lager back there. Nice job to knock that away. Now it's going to be Bear across the line. Farina collides with Holt. Now they try to go to the slot area. Puck's loose to the near side. Kiffin now turns away. Now we're getting to that time of the game where anybody gets a chance. It gets dicey. That misses Batchelder and an icing call. Back the other way we go. Well, I've shouted him out once, and I think I'm going to do it again. So I think he is probably enjoying himself at some watering hole somewhere in Arkansas or Louisiana. Hello to Bart Archer. It's quite the game here at the Community Center. It's been amazing. Great to have you on board. Pouring now. This is going to be Quinn fanned on. Now it's going to be Brown with it. Feinberg, that's off the stick of Brown. And now Coring will watch this one into his own zone, and they're going to bring it all the way back to the skipper zone. Eagles have really been kind of cinching in a little bit here. There have been moments for the skippers, but let's think back with 4:58. When was the last time there was sustained zone time? Hard to do when you're killing penalties three times in a period now. That definitely can take its toll on you as well. Not saying the penalties were Minnetonka's fault or whatever, but fact is if that's the hand that's dealt, it's tough to get that offensive flow. Corey Shaw! That one came through, and that hit Hupke. He's going to limp off. Johnson the check there. Now it's going to be Langenbrenner behind his own net. Behind, oh, Newhouse is there to force a turnover with Caring. Now it's going to be Johnson, Langenbrenner. Off the boards, up high it goes. Conan's shot, missed the mark. Now it's going to be Jorgensen with it. He's going to calm it down, but take some pace through center. He got away from Newhouse, who stayed in position regardless, as Jorgensen now will poke this one back behind. Kiffin around the wall it goes. Hannes comes away with it. Look out, Jorgensen spins him off the puck. You got to think the Marbles are going to change pockets at some juncture. I mean, anybody sitting in the stands would be saying that. One's going to be called on White. Now to the corner it goes. Now it's going to be Mittelstadt with it. Around the wall. Anything close, it's going to go. Now it's going to be sent right back in by Chartier. 3:57 to go. Mittelstadt with it now. He'll accelerate back up through the middle. Mittelstadt now surveys to the left for Holt. Batchelder looks for Holt. And now it's going to be played back off the boards into the corner. Now it's going to be set to the left wing side. Oh, big check thrown there on Bear. Back in behind it goes. Now it's going to be Harris behind. Hendrickson is there. Looks out front. That's off Batchelder. Giffen gloves down at the line. Batchelder, oh, look out, out of the zone to the right wing side for Blake. And they're offside at the line. That was a 3-on-2, though, but due to the back pressure from the skippers, became a 3-on-3 and a forced play and an offside. I think some people are not sure on that one. Brown. Brown to the corner he goes. For Lula. Now Newhouse looks back up through the middle. Carrying with it. Finds Lula. Brown. Now knocked down by Lagerback. Eagles will get it back. They're content to just throw it right back in. We're under 3 minutes now. 2:55 to go. Knotted at three. Feinberg the body. Now it's Conan. Brown watches him. Conan to the right wing side for Lagerback. Deflected to center. Now Lagerback plays behind. Set right back in. Steered up out of play. I don't think that for Zach Hayes wanted that to go. But that one was offside anyway. So they'll go to center ice on this one. Bear takes over. He'll look and survey. That one misses the mark. Now it's going to be Peppers. Holt held in by Kiffin. That one takes a funny deflection. Now it's going to be Langfeld's with it. Mittelstadt to the right wing for Blake. Finds Holt. Back for Batchelder. Held in at the line by Mittelstadt, back in behind. Holt knocks down Kiffin to the near boards. It's Peppers. Batchelder wins the battle. Look out behind the net. Oh, that one took a funny carom off Kiffin. In toward Griesmeister, who is Johnny on the spot to shut that one down. Wow. .158 to go here in the third. Face-off win, Langenbrunner shot through the screen and in on goal. Briesmeister squares up. We all know the overtime rules here in high school hockey. If it goes to that, it's a 3-minute rest break, followed by 8 minutes. If we don't get it done, we go do the ice and we start it back up. Konen takes over behind the net. Long pass ahead. Chartier watched by Kering. Over to the far boards it goes. The Skippers with that 3-1 lead in the second period have seen it disappear to 3-0. Eagles have two power play goals. It's going to be Hendrickson across the line. And now it's Brown with it as he's going to accelerate with strength, size, and speed. But beautiful play by Konen. Look at that, textbook. Over to the left wing side it goes as he tries to push it to the near boards for Kiffin. That was beautiful by Konen. Now Kiffin protects from Brown. Harris with it with 1:10 to go in the third. At center, Mittelstadt will make the read. He's going to have to wait in on goal as that one's turned. So I wouldn't have counted if it went in. They're offside. Now Blake comes away with it. Chips to the boards. It's going to be Newhouse. Oh, somehow Blake kicked that away. Now it's going to be Langfels with under a minute to go. 50. Now Luke Mittelstadt, Blake across the line. Jackson Blake lays it over to the right wing side for Batchelder. Batchelder, now Blake with it. They play this one down the wall. That's going to be Bear who turns this one to center. Quinn with it. He is run into by Batchelder. Luke Mittelstadt now with 30. To the right wing side for Batchelder across the line. Batchelder back door for Holt. That one rattles to the slot area. Now it's Mittelstadt back into the corner. Holt finds Blake. He's dangerous. Goal line shot, save, rebound, pucks loose. Oh, Batchelder took a swing at that one. Now 14 to go. Now it's Bear with it. Off the glass to center. That's going to make it for an icing call. And this will be interesting to see. Sean Golds really wants a timeout for the faceoff. But then again, do you want to give the Eagles a chance to have a set play and work on that? Probably not. Carter Batchelder knows the importance of this faceoff, no question. As does Hunter Newhouse, or check that, Drew Holt knows the importance. As does Hunter Newhouse. They got Batchelder offset to the right. Nice job by Newhouse. Quick hands to the corner. Konen's going to eat it, ladies and gentlemen. We have overtime. All right, folks, the chat's going to be turned off. Warned you at the start of the game. It's got to be ridiculous, so we're shutting you up. So hopefully you guys can enjoy the game and not... For those that have been wonderful on the chat, thank you so much. But we're not putting up with this garbage. All right, so on that note, we got about a buck and a half to go to the start of the period. Takes a couple bad apples to ruin it for everybody. We're happy for you. Get your own damn show. We'll have more coming up for you right after this. And ladies and gentlemen, here we go into the overtime period. Next goal wins. We're going to work it for... Oh, wait, they lost a second on the clock. So they'll have to reset it. Is that a final? Why, Zeta and Benil are 3-2 as we hear, as that one's coming down to the wire. Here we go, folks. Next goal wins. It's Keppers from the right wing side. Knocked ahead by the stick of Hannes. Langfels will watch the roller into his own zone. Now Middlestad comes away. He'll have to regroup back up for Langfels. Now it's going to be Holt with it. We'll see if this is cautious or if... What happens? Blake shot, nice save. Friesmeister turns that one away. Cool. Very solid in goal. Luke Middlestad gloves it down. Little shot. Keeps it alive. Nice play there by the big-time D-man. Ooh, they had Newhouse flying out of the zone, but it's cut off at center. Middlestad and Hannes on the near boards. Middlestad sends that one back into the far corner. Eagles will change on the fly. Oh, that's cut off by Brown. Ooh, they were lucky. They could have had too many. And now it's going to be, look out, Newhouse can fly to the right wing side. He's got Kehring now helping out his Langenbrunner. Kehring, nice defensive play there by the sophomore. Terrific work. Now it's going to be off the boards. Now Langenbrunner, he has Holt with him, Feinberg angles. Langenbrunner comes together with Conan, who's been a physical force here for the Skippers. Now it's Hendrickson across the line, loads and shoots. That deflects off the gear of Kehring up and out of play. Hendrickson, the draw. Conan the shot. Oh, that nearly snuck under the pad of Hayes. Now it's Feinberg across the line. He's watched on the play. Hupka's on him. Now Brown tries to fish that one. Free rolling puck. Langfels pushes it through. Oh, tough save there. That thing knuckled in on the goaltender, Briesmeister. Now it's Brown, reaches for that one. Turns away from traffic. Now Brown back up for Langfels. Risser scores! Paul Feinberg! And the Eagles punch the ticket to the state tournament with an overtime win just minutes in against the Minnetonka Skippers. Oh my word! Riku Brown kept that whole play alive down off the side of the net. Did an incredible job to keep that alive. Langfels had a couple of opportunities. Cam Langfels gets it, feeds it down low, and there's a redirect. Quite the hockey game. For Phil Feinberg, his his second goal of the season. I'm sure he can't think of a goal that would be any better for him than that one. Wow. Well, they're down on the ends. A lot of these players are hugging each other from both the teams because they know each other so well. The COVID policy of the handshake lines are completely forgotten about. And I actually kind of love it. So we're going to keep the camera going here for the award ceremonies as they will hand out the medals. Tough loss for the Skippers. Did everything they could to earn a win. Had a two-goal lead at 3-1. Battled, were tough, and hard-nosed the whole way. Just a terrific, terrific hockey game. Wow. Don't know what else to say. Quick final for you. Wyzetta punches their ticket as they head off to the state tournament with a 3-2 win over the Red Knights of Benilde St. Margaret's. A one-goal game there. I mean, what more can you ask for here, folks? There you have it, your final score. The Eagles 4, the Skippers 3. We'll turn it downstairs to Joe Cook, the public address, and the award ceremonies in this one.
Number 30, Irene. Number 33,
There it is, folks. It's in the books. The Eagles heading off to the state tournament. They and the Skippers in a memorable one here from the Eden Prairie Community Center. For John Sands, who is clipping the highlights, getting the job done. Nice work, buddy. And our entire team here. This puts a wrap on a season that's been absolutely terrific as we have, I don't know, we've been from pillar to post doing tons of games, youth and high school. Been a lot of fun, so we'll be back big time again next year, looking forward to it. MN Hockey TV will be bigger and better than ever before as we continue to make our mark in high school sports. We started all this with myfoxhockey.com, then we brought you the mnhockeyhub.com, and now we bring you MN Hockey TV as we continue to put our footprint on this great game of high school hockey. That's going to do it. Your final score, the Eden Prairie Eagles 4 and the Minnetonka Skippers 3. I'm Pete Wagner. So long, everybody.